Alrighty, it is WrestleMania weekend, and what better way to send you guys off to WrestleMania 33 than with a WrestleMania Q&A video. Oh boy, how exciting. For those of you that are actually down at WrestleMania right now in Orlando, I hope you guys are having the time of your lives. Hopefully someday, maybe I can join y'all. Imagine the Schlag Daddy at WrestleMania. Y'all don't know a party until you get me involved. Anyways, moving on. Let's go ahead and get started with this Q&A and let's see what happens here. MacDog714 starts us off by asking, where should WrestleMania 35 be at? I think they should go to the US Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. What do you think? That's a realistic choice, a realistic option for them. I think they're about due for another Canadian WrestleMania. So the Sky Dome in Toronto would be a possibility. One of these years, they need to do it somewhere like London would make a ton of sense, even if it brings its logistical challenges. I'm not sure as of yet. Then he also asked, would you ever want to go to a WrestleMania live one day? Well, I can tell you this much. I'm now 36. I feel like I'm as close to the grave as I am to the womb. I'm getting really close to that midlife crisis, if you will. As a result, yes, I have a monster bucket list. I was sitting there thinking about it the other day. I'm like, there's all these things that I want to do in my life that I just haven't done for a plethora of reasons. One of the things that's near the top of the list is going to a WrestleMania. I have one goal right now, and that is, I believe it's April 8th, 2018, the Mercedes-Benz Superdome, New Orleans, Louisiana. I can say with relative certainty, the Schlag Daddy is planning on being there. Is it going to happen? We shall see. Fate tends to be cruel to me. Karma is a motherfucker, even though I don't know where the karma comes from. But at the end of the day, what'll probably happen is I'll have everything lined up. I'll get reservations set up. I'll get ready to buy the tickets. Then something will come up and all of a sudden, bam, I can't fucking go. But as of right now, I want to be there WrestleMania 34. As I think it's something I need to do. It's something I've wanted to do for years. It's something I've never been able to do. So I want to do it. And I want to go. And man, oh man, could you imagine the Schlag Daddy at WrestleMania in the French Quarter? That's all I'll say for now. Yes, I'm planning to go and I want to go next year. Antonio Vargas, thoughts on the reports that Cena versus Taker was planned for WrestleMania, but Vince overruled the writers and made Taker versus Reigns. That sounds about right. That sounds like something Vince would do. Take the match that would have far more mass appeal and far more interest and far more story behind it and throw it by the wayside because you have to throw everything behind Roman Reigns. Here's what I'll say about this. Is that if you were going to insist on giving Roman Reigns a big featured match at WrestleMania, fine. And if you felt like you didn't want to do John Cena versus The Undertaker WrestleMania for whatever variety of ridiculous reasons there are, fine. Then do John Cena versus Roman Reigns. Because that'll evoke all types of emotions across a variety of philosophies across the whole wrestling landscape and spectrum. I'm not surprised. It reeks of Vince that this was Vince's call. David L. Hadley, what's your opinion on smaller companies having shows all weekend during WrestleMania weekend? It's called good business. It's what the hell they should be doing. The ROHs of the world, the other independent shows. Of course, I don't think Impact Wrestling has a show scheduled down there. Why the fuck would they? Because that would make fucking sense. Absolutely. Why would you not? Because there are some people that might be down there that couldn't get tickets to the NXT TakeOver show or actually couldn't get tickets to WrestleMania. This is a way to suck in some of those fans. It's also a way to suck in some of those fans that are there for WrestleMania and they happen to catch your product. And maybe it's people that have watched an ROH, let's say, for years on TV, but they've never actually been able to go to a live show because they haven't been in their area or they haven't had the opportunity. Now here's a chance to get them further invested in your product by getting them to go. Absolutely. I think as many small companies as possible that have the resources to be able to do so should be running Their biggest show of the year, kind of adjacent to, kitty corner to WrestleMania. It's what a smart company does. It's what the hell they should be doing. Somebody talking about Reigns is super stupid and overrated as a wrestler, yet he has a... Sorry, man. You got a profile pic of the Uber driver. Pop me kettle, I'm just saying. Thunder Lips for Life. Do you think racist Vince will realize Mr. T and Mike Tyson were mega catalysts for launching the two biggest eras at WrestleMania? I believe both of them are in the WWE Hall of Fame, aren't they? And I think they, for years, have alluded to just how critical Mike Tyson is, and as a result, also have alluded to the impact and importance of Mr. T. Now, when we want to get into the racist part of Vince, I'm with you all the way. You know, I've been a big mouthpiece and talking head when it comes to this for years, ever since they started doing this crap. But the racist Vince label does not apply to the treatment of Mr. T and Mike Tyson in terms of how they have been treated in general and in the grand scheme of things in terms of talking about their legacy, their impact on WrestleMania and the WWF / WWE as a whole. That's not the battle you want to fight because that is a losing battle. Talk about the lack of black world champions, the stereotypical gimmicks that the talents are given. Those are much more appropriate talking points because they are absolutely fair. Absolutely legitimate complaints. This is not one of them. Demon Studios, who should be the one that retires The Undertaker? And what do you think of the designs of the NXT Championship titles? Haven't peeped the new designs because, frankly, I don't care. In terms of the one that retires The Undertaker, in my opinion, nobody should retire The Undertaker other than The Undertaker. He is the type of guy that at his last WrestleMania, and if this is the one, then so be it. At his last WrestleMania, he deserves the main event, and he deserves to go out a winner. Because of his impact, because of his legacy, because of how much he has meant to the company for so many years, for how much he has sacrificed and given to the business, both physically, and I argue too financially, because of Taker staying in his gimmick for so many years, particularly as a dead man, he's missed out and not taken part in so many things in terms of movies, in terms of television, in terms of endorsements and so on that could have made him money many times over what he actually did because he was so committed to The Undertaker and The Undertaker character. So nobody should be able to retire The Undertaker. It still pisses me off to this day that they ended the fucking streak because it's dumb, especially since the fact that he continued wrestling at WrestleMania. Taker should have been able to go out 25-0, and you'll never be able to convince me that there's anything other than that. Horror Movie Review 73, what are the top five WrestleManias from the past you wish you could have attended in person? WrestleMania 1, WrestleMania 3, WrestleMania 14, WrestleMania 18, because I wanted to see Hogan and Rock in person, and then probably if I had to choose one other one, WrestleMania 25, even though it wasn't a great show, it still had Taker versus Michaels 1 at Mania. So those are probably the five that I could think of. I mean, there are others too. In theory, I'd love to have gone to all of them, but that would be one right there. Edgar Zavala, what main event do you think will make more money? The Uber driver versus the suspect Sissy or Sid's leg versus Sackow and Sled? He went to the skid row because Johnny Ace said he needed to expand his office at repertoire. So sin it happened. Oh my God. And of course, one of the people in the match was Scott Steiner. He went up to the skid row and gave the big boot of doom. Gotcha! Absolutely. That's the moneymaker right there. Somebody asked me, TT99FM, any prediction on the size of Carl Flair's dick? # penis power. Somebody apparently did a video about last year talking about Charlotte Flair exposed as a man, even though when I looked at this person's channel, he says everybody's exposed as like transgendered as a fucking man. Charlotte's packing. Let's put it that way. I would say ask Paige, but she likes the black man. Jerry Longasuari, worst WrestleMania match you have seen? In terms of the buildup, in terms of the participants involved, in terms of the moment in time, the venue, everything. Bill Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar, WrestleMania 20. People want to take the easy way out and they want to say Undertaker versus Giant Gonzalez at WrestleMania 9 and some of the other ones. But for me, based off of expectations, based off of hype, based off of everything that ended up going down in the lead up to that match and the match itself, Lesnar, Goldberg, you've never seen two guys who gave fewer fucks and cared less about a featured match at the biggest stage of them all in the business. That to me is the worst match in WrestleMania history, and to me it's not close. The Ben Wardy asks, what would be your idea for a grand entrance? The perfect one, the absolute perfect one for me, would be to have Serena Williams hooked up to me, bent over, so I'd be banging her doggy style while I have some other hot sister fucking sitting there riding on my shoulders and I'm face down in their muff. If you want to think about a grand entrance for the Schlag Daddy, that's it right there. That's it. Entertainment Nation, do you plan on going to a future WrestleMania? Have you gone in the past? I never have. I would love nothing more than be able to go to 34. That's the goal. Chairman O, thoughts on Asuka and Nakamura when they get called to the main roster and the potential appeal to the Japanese market? We'll see how much that appeal to the Japanese market matters at the end of the day. Furthermore, I'm going off of WWE's history with Asian talents, which is about as dreadful as their history with black talents. I have zero confidence that they will do what can be done with these individuals. I'm sorry. You know, I hope to be proven wrong. It may very well be proven wrong. But I think at this point in time, if you automatically assume that these two, both woman and man, are going to sit there and be rocket shipped to the top, based off of history, you're being fucking delusional. In terms of these two, I don't see what the big deal is. But again, get your flaming keyboard fingers of fire ready and blast away on me in the comment section about how I hate Japanese wrestling. I don't give a shit. Baseline Jones, should they keep the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal or scrap it? There's a part of me that says scrap it because it comes about 2 months after the Royal Rumble. But there's also a part of me that says you should keep it. It should be on the main card since it's named after Andre. And it should be what it's supposed to be intended to be, which is supposed to be a big launching point for somebody. We'll see. But for now, they should keep it because if anything else, all else fails, even if it's on the pre-show, it gives an opportunity for all these people that have been around throughout the course of the year that don't have anything else going on for Mania to still be a part of the WrestleMania experience. And for that reason and that reason alone, I don't want to see them scrap it. And that's frankly part of the reason they do it. Let's not kid ourselves. It's to get everybody involved in Mania as much as they possibly can. And I'm okay with that. Wrestling 6798, the over-under of 15 minutes of Brock Goldberg, including entrances. Including entrances. I'm going to go over. Including entrances, I'm going to go over. Then he also asked, which match are you most looking forward to? Mine's a toss-up between Bray and Randy and Triple H and Seth. Why are you looking forward to Bray versus Randy? Oh, God. Let's hope, if anything else, since at least they're in Orlando, they're here on the East Coast, let's at least hope that the SmackDown World Title match, the WWE Championship match, isn't the curtain jerker, because again, it's what I talked about at WrestleMania 31, how stupid and fucking ridiculous it looked for Bray Wyatt to be coming out during the fucking day. Part of the whole thing with this Fireflies is you need it to be dark in the arena or the stadium so that way people can actually see it. So hopefully they at least wait until 8:30-ish time frame to send those guys out. But we'll see if they do. In terms of matches I'm looking forward to the most, I've already talked about it a little bit in the preview and predictions. The Cruiserweight title match on the pre-show. I'll actually be watching the pre-show because of that match. There's a part of me that looks forward a little bit to Triple H and Seth Rollins, although it really veered off course. It became about Seth Rollins' knee more than the story between the two of them, which I think is unfortunate. I'm looking forward to Lesnar Goldberg still. Roman Reigns, The Undertaker. I got to look forward to that one. There are matches that I am looking forward to. It just doesn't mean that I think this is going to be a great show. Dylan Johnson, my personal favorite WrestleMania match of all time. My personal favorite from an actual work standpoint or an actual wrestling standpoint is Taker Michaels 1 at 25, even though, of course, the WWE are fucking morons and they put that on in the middle of the fucking card. From a history standpoint, it's Hogan Andre, WrestleMania 3. In terms of just an experience and the awesomeness of the moment, I might go Hogan Rock at WrestleMania 18. Wrestling 6798, one more question. Why the fuck was Aries versus Neville left off the main card in favor of the SmackDown Women's Clusterfuck match? That's a good question. That's a very good question. They don't care about the cruiserweights, and they feel like it fits on the pre-show. One of those things to get the hardcore fans into the event early on, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, that SmackDown Women's match sounds like a clusterfuck of suck. I'd rather have Aries versus Neville on the main card. You know, I look at some of the matches on the card. It's like, I get the Raw tag title matches on the main card, at least as of my recording of this, because it's a ladder match. Cool. You've already got the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal on the kickoff show. Dumb, but whatever. Cool. But like, Corbin versus Ambrose for the IC title. They didn't even have these guys on fucking SmackDown, I don't think, on Tuesday. Why the fuck are they on the main card? You didn't even care enough to put them on your go-home edition of SmackDown. That match should be moved to the fucking kickoff show, and Neville Aries should be put in its place, my opinion. Gustavo Camacho, say Taker and Reigns main events. Your thoughts on Reigns joining God, Hogan, Rock, and Cena on having 3+ consecutive Mania main events? Well, if you're trying to build him up as your big dude, if you're trying to make him that next franchise player, it would make sense that he would have 3 consecutive WrestleMania main events. Because typically your biggest star, your biggest name, your biggest guy should be in the story that commands the main event of Mania, because he's supposed to be the top draw. He's supposed to be the guy that is able to deliver the goods and bring it home. You know, and it'll be easy to just sit there and crap on Reigns and say, "Whoa, God, it speaks to the company and how bad it is that you put him in this spot and da, da, da." You know, part of that is true, and the other part of that is, who the fuck else you got in terms of future guys? You don't fucking have them. So what the fuck's the difference? I'm just saying. Luke Winstanley, do you think WWE should take WrestleMania to the UK within the next 3 or 5 years? Yes. How close that is to a reality, I don't know. I don't know if they would choose a SummerSlam or a Survivor Series first before WrestleMania. I would rather them go do a SummerSlam at Wembley Stadium, let's say, and use that again as a practice run, because it's been 25 years since they did it. I'd be a fan of them doing that to work on some of the kinks, figure out some of the things, try some different things, and see how it works. Mr. Pyle 1, most memorable WrestleMania day. Not the show itself per se, but that day in general. Most memorable WrestleMania day. You have me stumped. I don't know. That's a very, very good question. Very, very good question. Juggernaut John, how will the Breakfast Club do at this year's WrestleMania? Make a lot of money. Which is what it's about. Boom. Grace X Lord, do you think the Hardys will show up? And would you want the broken gimmicks in WWE? I think they're showing up, if not at WrestleMania, maybe the Raw after Mania. I'm okay with the broken gimmicks in WWE. Why not? Shake up the presentation a little bit. Little DJ Boy, favorite WrestleMania set? I don't know. You know, it's not something I take that seriously. You know, if the set looks cool, that's great. It helps, but it's not really something I pay much attention to in the grand scheme of things in terms of remembering. Like, I know some people care about the sets, and they talk about the sets, and they think about the sets, and they say, this set is their favorite, that set is their favorite. I'm just happy that they actually have a set for WrestleMania. Mr. Sarah Vale. Who wins between Taker and Roman, and do you believe that this is Taker's last WrestleMania? You know, I've believed before that it was Taker's last WrestleMania and been wrong. I think he's getting to that point where he wants to get that hip replacement surgery. I think there's a good chance that this would be his 25th WrestleMania. This would be an appropriate time to go out. Shame to have him go out in this, with this match, at this moment in time. If he's leaving, I think there's going to be a major push to have him put over Roman. And, oh, God. I'll tackle that monster when I get to it. How about that? Mark Stephen Barnes, I know how much you hate today's product, but you have to agree that on paper this looks like a pretty good show. No, I don't have to fucking agree that this looks like a pretty good show. I feel like several of the talents are underutilized, misutilized. Several of the matches I don't give a fuck about. That on paper does not look like a good fucking show. It absolutely does not. I mean, come on. Another major matches I feel like are very predictable in terms of the way they're going to play out and the way they finish. No, I don't have to agree this is a pretty good show on paper, because it's not. Looks like a shit show on paper. Okay, Martin Hall, what will be the last ever WrestleMania and who will main event? The Breakfast Club. They're going to call it Breakfast Club Mania. Ahmed LW, why do you think the crowd turned on Goldberg? He got booed at the Hall of Fame and he will get booed at WrestleMania. Fucking retards. I mean, wasn't there somebody saying shit during Eric LeGrand's speech? I mean, wrestling fans are just tools and morons. Why did they turn on him? Maybe they're pissed off about the fact that he's in one of the featured marquee matches and a world title match at that at Mania. And I understand some of that. No reason to really boo him because he'll be gone after that. So fuck off. But you're going to cheer Lesnar, the guy who ended Taker's streak and is only around part-time himself. And frankly, he's gotten very repetitive and boring in his presentation outside of what he's done with Goldberg. Just saying. Pablo, Cena versus Taker at Mania 34 to retire The Undertaker. How would you book the feud? I wouldn't. Because I'm not retiring Taker by having John Cena beat him. Chris Toronto, how would you book the finish to Taker versus Roman? After hearing the Ultimate Thrill Ride one more time, as Roman thinks that victory is close at hand, here comes, bam, last ride, tombstone, 1, 2, 3, Taker wins, bitches. That's how you book that shit. Huggermania asks, excitement levels for Huggermania. If we're referencing WrestleMania, excitement's is building up a little bit as we get closer to it because, again, it is WrestleMania, and I'm really hopeful for something that's really going to please me and really surprise me with the show. Excitement for Bayley and her match is about zero, so on you. My thoughts on the WrestleMania 33 stage are taking this Ultimate Thrill Ride shit too far, building that what was a little fucking roller coaster there and shit. It looks cool. Let's see here. Marvin D, do you think the New Day will get involved in an impromptu match of some sort? If anything, they might have a stare down with, like, the Hardys. If the Hardys were going to be there. I don't know. They'll have a segment. But I don't know if they'll have a match. I think that's about it. Yeah, that's all the time I got. I got other shit to do because I can't get ready for WrestleMania. So thanks, guys, for your questions. I will try to have the WrestleMania 33 review up immediately after tonight's show. Unfortunately, that means I'm cutting out the characters and this and that. It's going to be kind of freeform and just fucking go with it. But that's what I'm going to try and do. We're going to see what happens. Hopefully it works. Thanks, you guys, for your questions. See you.